Hi, welcome to an Inventor 2019 video tutorial. I want to do that advanced rim exercise in Inventor. Went pretty well. So, let's have fun with Inventor. So, in order to save some time, I will reuse a sketch which I did in my simple rim exercise. You can proceed with the same dimensions or you can change them. After all, it's just an exercise. I want to do a revolve. I want to create a surface with this profile and around that axis and confirm. So I want to use the Z axis and the Y Z plane as reference and create two more new planes. So go for plane. Choose axis, choose reference plane, and the angle should be 15. Another one, again, YZ plane, Z axis, but this time it's minus 15. Nice. Now I want to see that sketch as reference. And let's do a 2D sketch on that plane right here. And this might be a line which starts here and then an arc, maybe like this. Okay, let's move this down a little bit, maybe here, yeah, for example. Finish that sketch. Next sketch on that plane. Again, a line followed by an arc. Let's move this down a little bit. Maybe like this. Okay. Finish that sketch as well. Now I could probably hide those two, at least for the moment. And I could, yeah. Now I could hide that sketch. Now I need two more planes through that point and normal to that curve, and another one like this. And of course I can do that on the other end as well, it doesn't really matter. Then I need a sketch on this plane. I need that point. So go for project geometry and project that point. I need an arc. So those two points should be aligned, horizontal or vertical, that's the question. Yep. Now I should be able to. Yeah, seems that's not the center point right here. So this point, that one and this midpoint of that one should be aligned. So let's remove that constraint and delete that projected point, yes, and project it once more, okay, and now go for coincidence. This point should be right here, that's it, and now I'm able to make this a little bit more like that, yeah, okay. Finish that sketch And another sketch right there. Again, project that point. Use an arc. Those two points should be horizontally aligned, and that projected point should be coincident to the midpoint of that arc. Okay, now let's make this bigger, maybe like that, and finish that sketch. Now I want to do two sweeps. So before a sweep, that's the profile. So maybe it's already selected. So deselect, sweep, go for the profile and the path. Okay. Go for profile and path. Okay. Now I can already trim. So I want to trim with this tool. This should be removed and that should be removed. So apply, trim tool, and remove. Okay. Now I need a sketch and my center plane. That would be this one. So let's show it. And of course I can already trim with that plane. Take a look. This part over here, that's this one. Apply, same plane as trim tool, and remove that side. Okay. Now I need a sketch on the, that's the XY plane in this case. And I need a line which goes to the center and over here. So this could be vertical, no. In this case that's horizontal aligned. And I could do it with a construction line. Now, which means that point here and that point in this case are vertical aligned. The angle should be 60 degrees. Finish that sketch. Now I can trim with that sketch. Let's go to trim. That's the tool. And I want to remove this side. Let's show that sketch and make it reusable. Share sketch and do another trim with the same tool. Remove this side. Okay. Do you need that sketch? No, I can hide it. So another sketch on the XY plane in this case. Circle, diameter might be 100. Now I can use that as trim tool. Trim with that circle. Remove this part. Apply again. Share it. And do another trim. Remove that side. Okay. Let's hide that plane. And another sketch on the XY plane. So that would be in this case the top plane. So the XY plane, another sketch there. That would be just a line. Like this. Finish the sketch. And make a surface extrude with that line. And make it 290. Okay. Now a sketch on the YZ plane. One straight line. Maybe like this. And one line and arc. For example, finish that sketch, and now let's trim with those two lines that face. So go for trim, and that sketch would be the cutting tool. Apply, share it. Trim once more, and okay, another trim with that tool removes this one, and another trim with this circle right here. Remove that side, okay. And hide that sketch. And I could hide that plane and this plane. And that surface. And this should be hidden. Now I can go for my thickening. Okay. But I forgot I need another sketch. So maybe hide this one. Let's sketch. This one. Another sketch on the XY plane. I will need as reference those two planes. Oh, those two planes. So make them visible or just project the geometry of those two inside my sketch. So this one and that one. And of course make it for construction purpose only. Nice. So I need a circle which is somehow on that maybe like this and put that center point onto that plane. It's already there, so I snapped. Great. Maybe a little bit smaller, maybe like this. Okay, then I need lines and try not to snap. So this point should be on that one, this point should be on this one, and I might project the YZ plane as well. So go to project geometry, YZ plane, okay, and make this for construction only. Now this one and that one should be parallel, this one and that one should be parallel as well. There should be an angle, and that angle should be 30. And another angle again, 30. So let's move this a little bit up. Now fill it maybe 20 and another one, but that should not be equal, so undo this and do a new one. Let's change this to 10 and that might move up a little bit. Yeah, more like this. Great. Add a dimension. Maybe 15 here as well. 15. Yeah, looks okay. And finish this sketch and maybe, just maybe, move this a little bit. Yeah. Finish that sketch and I can use that sketch, but I could share it beforehand. No, I have to use it and then share it. Great. So let's go for trim. That's my trim tool, that sketch. Kind of awkward. Should be removed. Apply. Now I can share that sketch. Do another trim with that sketch, remove this one and apply, use that circle and apply. Now I could hide that sketch and now I can do thickened surfaces. So let's go to thicken. I want it 5 millimeter. To the upper side, apply. This one, apply that one in both directions. I could go for more, let's say for 6, and of course I made one slight error. These have to be different bodies, so check this one out, make a new body. Okay. Now thicken this surface, symmetric. Yeah, so that would be 3 and 3. A new body, and okay. Let's use fillets. This would be 3 millimeter on this edge, that one, and that one. Let's do a shell with 2 millimeter thickness. I want to remove this side, that one, this one. This one and that one. Okay. Great. Another shell over here. Remove this surface, that surface, this one, and of course that one. Okay. Now let's add fillets. Let's go for 1 millimeter fillets. This edge, that one, this one, and that one. Apply. This edge, this one, that one, apply. Nope, no possible, so cancel this. Why? Cancel this out. Maybe I selected the wrong one. So fill it. This edge, that edge. This one doesn't work. No, that one doesn't work. Okay. So I should go for, let's say, 0.9. This edge. Okay. Next fillet one. This edge, that edge, this one, and let's see. Okay, now I want to pattern that body 3 times. So go for a circular pattern, go for a body. I want to use this one. Rotation axis would be the Z axis. Yes, I want to have 3 and That's 60 degrees altogether, and it should be symmetric. Okay, now let's combine those. This should be one solid body, yes. Now let's hide those sketches. Which is the one? That's a plane. No. What are these yellow elements? Ah, the surfaces, of course. So hide those surfaces. Let's add some more fillets. Start with the ones down below, so go for a fillet. Let's use radius 5, should work. This edge. This one. This one. And that one. Apply. Take a look here. Can I use 5? Probably. Let's go for 3. Okay. Now another circular pattern. Again, I want to pattern a body. This body, yes. Rotation axis would be again the Z axis. This one. 6 instances, 360 degrees, and okay. So let's show that revolution surface. And give it some thickness. So go to thicken. I need a new body. And let's add to the quilt. 6 on both sides. That's okay. 3 on both sides. Altogether 6. Let's hide that surface body and give it some fillets. Maybe, yeah, 3 should work. On this edge, that one, this one, and maybe on that one. And this one and that one. Okay. Now let's combine those two. And see if we can make fillets here. So go for another fillet, let's say, let's try 3, might work. Not quite. So go for 2 millimeter. This works, yes. takes a while again. But it's faster than SolidWorks. Much faster. Okay. Another sketch on the XY plane in this case. Another circle. Diameter might be 160. Finish that sketch, make an extrude and make it, let's take a look, 265 maybe. Maybe 270. Yeah. But again, make it a new body. Let's add a chamfer right there. Two distances right here. Make it 10 and let's say 50. Switch it. Take a look. Yeah, maybe make this 15. And that 140. Or 35. Yeah, that's better. Looks good. Add another fillet on this edge, maybe 5. Okay, and now combine those two. Combine this body with that body. Okay. Let's add two more fillets. Let's see. Oh, this doesn't look so good right here, so I have to make this smaller. So that would be that extrude sketch, this one. So let's go for 4. Not possible to get to this one. Okay, so let's go direct to that sketch and edit that 160 to 150. And take a look. That's better. Of course, you could move that circle in that direction, which might be a good idea. And let's make that extrude. Where's the extrude? There's the extrude. Make it not 2.7. Make it 2.6. Yeah. And change that chamfer as well. This should be, yeah, needs a little tweaking. Let's go for 268. And make this shorter. So let's go for 30. No, 25. Yeah, that's better. And I want to move that circle a little bit if possible. Let's take a look. Which sketch? Not this one, that sketch. Yeah, sketch 17. Let's edit this one. And move this a little bit to that position. Let's hope it's not too big of a change. Yeah, this looks pretty good. Now let's add the fillets here. So let's try 5. Doesn't work. Let's try 3. No, let's try 2. This should probably work. Yeah. And another one. Right here. And fillet 5 should work. Nice. Now let's add a hole here. So go for hole. 60 millimeters might be okay. Select the face and move this one to the center. Confirm. And I think I'm done. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook Cat Fan page. I want to get more likes and subscriptions over there as well. So thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.